Learn how to run JavaScript code by using inline code in Azure Logic Apps in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. We are going to create a logic app that uses inline JavaScript. In order to reference values from previous logic app steps in JavaScript, we need to create an integration account and couple that with the logic app. So let's first create an integration account. There it is. And let's create one. I'll fill in a name here and select my existing resource group. Okay, let's create it. That's done. Now we'll create a new logic app. Search for logic app and here is the result. Okay, create. And again, I'll give it a name, like this, and select the resource group. And that's it. I'll skip ahead to when it's done. Here we are in the logic app. First, we need to couple the integration account. We can do that in workflow settings. And here, I can select the integration account and now save it. Okay, we're done with the plumbing. Now we can create the logic app process. We will start from scratch, so I'll select the blank logic app. All right, the process that we are going to build will get a text file from OneDrive and replace text in it. So first, we'll add a OneDrive trigger. I'll want to trigger when a file is created. When you use a OneDrive task for the first time, you need to sign into OneDrive. I've already done that. Now I'll select the folder that I'm going to put the text file in. And I'll change this to 10 seconds, so that we don't have to wait so long. Okay, next step. Now for the inline code. I'll use the execute JavaScript code action. This is pure JavaScript. Let me paste my code in here. This first takes the file content from the previous step, like this. We needed the integration account to access this object. You can also click any of these to insert references to the values in the code. So I'll take the text and replace the word portal with a lowercase portal. The G means that it replaces globally, so all instances in the text. And finally, I return the result. Okay, next step. OneDrive again. And I'll choose the update file action. I want to update the file that triggered the process. And here should be the result of the inline code. Sometimes you can't just select it. So I'll first rename the inline code action, like this. And now I can reference the result by typing body of the clean text action. All right, that should work. Save it and run it. Let's trigger it. Here in my local OneDrive folder, I've created a simple text file, which has the word portal in it a couple of times. Let's copy that to the folder that we are monitoring. And this triggers the logic app. There it is, it worked. Portal with a lowercase p. And let's see when we open the file. Yep, it updated the file as well. Cool. The ability to use inline code in a logic app process creates endless possibilities. With inline code, you can enhance the process in any way you like. You can build custom conditions and data manipulations and whatever else you need. Go and check it out.